beginning of what Diana referred to as a new series for the Los Angeles Press Club, how I got that story. And really, there is no better way to start that series off than with the two gentlemen who have been behind the story of the summer throughout Los Angeles. To my right is Jeff Gottlieb, and the far side there is Ruben Vives. They are both staff writers at the Los Angeles Times, and they have been consumed by the city of Bell this summer, a city that most of us had probably never even heard of, certainly not thought of a lot before they started digging into it. We're going to jump right into it in a few minutes, but maybe if we could just first start, if I could have each of you give us the quick 25-cent bio, where you're from, how long you've been at the Times, what you were doing before Bell consumed your life. Ruben, you picked up the microphone first, so we can start with you, please.
I want to get it over with. I have actually been with the Times for about 10 years now, but I've only actually started writing for the Times 3 years, almost nearly 3 years now. And started covering homicides for the paper, for the LA, the Homicide Report blog. So I covered that for about a year, and then moved over to the news desk, the morning news desk, which I wrote about everything from fires to shootings and all that other gory stuff. Then last August, I was assigned to cover the Southeast, and been covering that since then.
Thank you. And Jeff?
I've been at the Times for, I think, 13 years. Before that, I was at the Riverside Press Enterprise and the Herald Examiner and Sports Illustrated and San Jose Mercury News, both as a reporter and an editor. And before this happened, I was covering the South Bay, basically from the airport through San Pedro, periodically getting pulled into other stuff.
Great, thank you. Now, before we start jumping right into the story, just so we have a bit of context, can one of you tell us a little bit about Bell? What kind of city it is, population, economics, background, industrial, etc.?
Well, Bell is a 2-square-mile city. Has a population of about 40,000. Half are actually foreign-born. One of the poorest cities in the county. It is among actually one of the poorest cities in the county. And a lot of the people there are working class citizens. They usually just also are very uneducated. Most don't even have a high school diploma degree.
The city's 90% Latino.
That too.
All right, let's go on to the good stuff. In June, hundreds of thousands of Angelenos opened their Sunday Times to find a huge graph on the front cover, which we weren't used to seeing, and a shocking story about a city manager who was making nearly $800,000, city council members earning almost six figures for part-time work. Simple to the point. How did you guys get this story?
As I mentioned during the opening that I started covering the Southeast last August, and with that came covering going to council meetings. And so I was attending council meetings in Maywood, and I realized that they were one night, they were going to disband their police department. They were going to wipe out all their city employees. And in addition to that, they were going to contract law enforcement services with the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department, and they were going to contract city services with neighboring Bell. I think that's when we editors called in Jeff, and we basically wrote the story about the city of Maywood, sort of doing this, becoming a 100% contracted city. And while we were doing that, Jeff had, we were also inquiring to see whether there were any investigations going on in Maywood. And Jeff had called the district attorney's office and had asked, are you guys looking into anything in Maywood, any investigations going on in there? And they said, no, we're not, but we're inquiring about Bell. And I think Jeff asked, well, what's going on in Bell? And we're inquiring about their salaries, so they're pretty high up there. And Jeff, you want to take it from there?
Yeah. pretty much it was, you know, asking about Maywood, you know, anything going on in Maywood, and they said, well, there are other agencies involved in Maywood. And I said, what about Bell? And it was like, oh, yeah. And so we then wrote a story saying that they were, the DA was investigating Bell for the nearly $100,000 a year salaries the council people were getting, and these are part-time jobs. We didn't know that they were getting these $100,000 salaries, let alone being investigated, so we did that story. And that then rang bells, to use a pun, to me. It reminded me very much of a story I had done when I was at the San Jose Mercury News. That was a story about the East Palo Alto Sanitary District. East Palo Alto is not Palo Alto. It's across the railroad tracks, literally. Very poor city, one of the poorest in the Bay Area. And the Sanitary District, those are the people who take care of the sewers. They had built this Taj Mahal building as an office. And I did a big project on what was going on there, on their expenses, and I found that the board members were traveling around the country, staying in fancy hotels, eating at fancy restaurants, spending lots of money, rental cars, spending lots of money on other things, and I think one or two people were charged. And that's what this reminds me. It just seems so outrageous that these guys in Bell would be making $100,000 a year. So Ruben and I then decided, okay, we'll go to Bell and we'll go see if we can, you know, look and see what kind of expenses these guys, how much money these guys are spending. And honestly, that's what we were looking at. So we go to Bell City Hall, go to the front counter, and we say, can we speak to the city manager? He won't come to the counter. Ding, ding, ding. Then we, the city clerk, we tell her what we want, which included minutes of council meetings, expenses, the city manager's contract. You know, I mean, like, just walk down and give us the damn stuff and let us look at it. She pulls out a form and says, okay, you guys have to fill out a public records request. So we sort of figure, okay, fine, you know, that's like for their bookkeeping purposes or whatever. And we fill it out and we say, okay, you can give it to us now? And she says, no, you're going to have to wait 10 days. I sort of look at her, kind of astonished, and then I ask for a copy of that form, and she gives me a copy and charges me $1. And so then about every day, one of us would call the city clerk and ask, are we going to get this stuff? And when we'd actually talk to her, you know, we'd say, you know, if we don't want to sue you, but we will. And if we, and then when we go to court and we win, because we will ask the judge to make you guys pay our legal bills, which is part of the Public Records Act.
I think also to add to that, we got asked to inspect these documents. You know, by law, by state law, you are, as a citizen, you have every right to, and, you know, if you can't even get copies, she should be able to walk over to the cabinet, pull out those minutes, bring it to you, here you go, you can look at it. And we asked, and she said, I can't do it today. I just can't do it, I got other stuff to do. And we just thought, okay.
At that point, did you know that there was something wrong in Bell? Is that what really?
Well, it seemed like it. I mean, it's like, you know, give us the minutes, there are these green binders, just give them to us and I'm gonna look at it, what's the big deal?
So when did you figure out that Robert Rizzo, the city manager, was making what he was making?
We'll get to that. there's it's actually, you know, it's we think an interesting story.